Welcome to the National Weather Service briefing for a significant rain and wind storm that will impact Southern Oregon and Northern California through Monday. Our concerns are for heavy rain west of the Cascades, leading to flooding, landslides, and debris flows in recent burn scar areas of western Siskiyou County. Strong winds are expected over the ocean and near the coast and at higher elevations inland. The strong winds will create dangerous seas and high surf up to around 25 feet. This is a very large storm that will impact the region from Seattle to San Francisco. Major impacts could be river flooding, especially for small streams. Strong winds may down trees and cause power outages. There will be dangerous ocean fishing conditions, and this storm will have a negative impact on winter outdoor recreation as the already meager snowpack will likely diminish. The rain will be good for the drought in the short term, especially near the coast. This satellite view Wednesday morning shows moisture in mainly the middle part of the atmosphere. When we talk about an atmospheric river, otherwise known as a Pineapple Express, this satellite view doesn't always include the abundant moisture at the warmer low levels. If you look closely, you can see this abundant moisture originating near Hawaii and another area north of Hawaii. Much of the moisture in the atmosphere is found in the warmer lower layers of the atmosphere, and you'll see this more clearly in the next slide. This loop shows where the deep moisture is forecast to be transported in the atmosphere. This loop is the result of many computer forecasts averaged together, which we believe to be a more accurate forecast rather than just looking at one computer forecast. Northern California and far southwest Oregon may receive the most moisture through Sunday night. These were the weather watches, warnings, and advisories that were in effect as of Wednesday morning. They include flood watches, high surf advisories, storm warnings for the ocean, high wind watches, and wind advisories. Here are the rainfall amounts expected through Friday night. The heaviest rain will occur across Curry, Western Josephine, and Western and Southern Siskiyou counties. This will be a warm storm with snow levels mainly above 7,000 feet. Here is the total rainfall expected through Monday. Amounts decrease to the east and north. The greatest threat of flooding will be across areas that receive 6 or more inches of rain. Some areas will see strong winds both Thursday and Friday. The strongest winds over the ocean and at the coast are expected Thursday morning. A storm warning has been issued for the ocean. Farther inland, the strongest winds may occur Friday afternoon. Areas of concern are the Shasta Valley, the southern end of the Rogue Valley near Ashland, the Summer Lake area in Lake County, and any exposed high elevation site such as Crater Lake Rim. Despite the heavy rain, the CHETCO River near Brookings is not expected to reach flood stage. It is forecast to crest Friday night. The South Fork of the COQUILLE River at Myrtle Point is forecast to crest just below moderate flood Friday night into early Saturday. The COQUILLE River at COQUILLE is forecast to crest at minor flooding on Saturday and Saturday night. Other rivers across the region will see rises, but are not expected to flood. The Sprague River near Beatty is forecast to get close to minor flooding Saturday night into Sunday. The Scott River near Fort Jones will see a decent rise, but is still forecast to remain below flood stage this weekend. The main concern from this storm is for very heavy rain, which may lead to urban and small stream flooding, as well as flooding on the larger rivers near the coast. Landslides and debris flows are also possible, especially at the coast and the highways which lead to the coast. Ocean conditions will be dangerous for fishing through Friday, and high surf will pound the beaches, especially the south-facing areas. Winds are expected to be gusty on Thursday and Friday, and damaging winds are possible at the coast and across exposed higher elevations inland, as well as the Shasta Valley and the Summer Lake area. This rain will help the drought, but there is still a long way to go to fill the reservoirs, and the meager snowpack will likely diminish due to the very high snow levels. From all of us at the National Weather Service, we thank you for watching our weather briefing.